Thanks for joining me. I'm Tom Davis with News-Sentinel.com, and I'm here to preview the Purdue Boilermakers for the 2017-18 basketball season. And Boiler Nation is still riding high after last year's Big Ten championship. There were a lot of big reasons for that championship, none other bigger than Caleb Swanigan, Biggie, who's now with the Portland Trailblazers of the NBA. Will Purdue be able to overcome the loss of Swanigan? That's a yes and a no question, because I really like Purdue's starting five. When you look at Isaac Haas at 7'2" and Vince Edwards at 6'8" at the four, and then Dakota Mathias and Carson Edwards and PJ Thompson in the backcourt, that is a really, really good starting five. Probably as good as anybody in the Big Ten can roll out this year. However, the problem is after that, the depth is really, it's questionable for Purdue going into this season. Ryan Klein is a great shooter off the bench for him. In fact, Purdue's the best shooting team in the Big Ten, and Matt Painter talked about that recently, how good a shooting team that they are. But I'm really curious about their depth. They do have a 7'3 redshirt freshman in Matt Harms, who is showing potential in the preseason, and he's gotten a lot better than he was last year in practices when he wasn't playing. So they have some players. Nogel Eastern's a newcomer. Eden Ewing's a JUCO newcomer for them along the front court. So they've got some players, but whether they evolve into solid contributors in the Big Ten remains to be seen. But boy, that starting five, as good as they shoot the ball, as good as PJ Thompson takes care of the ball, Dakota Mathias guards, they've got so much talent in that starting five, but it's just a matter of who among the depth emerges into solid rotational players to help Purdue contend for a Big Ten championship this year. Can they contend for a championship? Boy, that's going to be tough, but I think that they're in the second, third, fourth place. They're definitely an NCAA tournament team. They're definitely in the Big Ten mix in early February as far as a title. I really like this program. I like the way they play. I like how smart the players are, how hard they work. They had a great summer, a better summer than any program in America, because they took part in 30 practices and 11 games as they represented the world, the USA in the World University Games. So they had a really productive summer, which will help leading into this season. But I think Purdue fans have to be happy. It's going to be a really good team. Whether they win a championship or not remains to be seen, but they're going to be in the mix, and they're going to be an NCAA tournament team. You can follow me for complete Purdue coverage beginning tomorrow night as they host Carroll for an exhibition. I'll be over in West Lafayette. You can follow me on Twitter at Tom101010. You can follow New Sentinel Sports at The NS Sports, and you can follow me on Facebook at Thomas Davis. So we'll see if it'll be a boiler up type of year for Purdue.